Quintet, which is a very famous brass quintet, has recorded a lot of his compositions. He's played in a lot of schools of music and concert halls, so we're very fortunate to have it. The next selection, Suite for Brass Quintet, by Mr. Verne Reynolds. Mr. Reynolds was a horn professor and composition teacher at Eastman School. He's known for writing a lot of great music, and really great music for the brass. He was an accomplished composer, an accomplished horn player, and as well as an accomplished scholar. We're very fortunate to have an opportunity to play this piece this evening, and I'd like to publicly thank my colleagues for putting all this work in for me.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
form and understand the intricacies of preparing things. And it's good that your students, that my students at least, know that I'm actually a musician, not some guy that's just a one stick in front of them. So I got together, called some guys up, and asked them if they want to play. These are the original guys here. It's Fred Lenz, it's Lee Brusino, it's Nathan Barnes. We started a trumpet player, Dan was one of our trumpet players, and we went through a couple of more trumpet players, and we were fortunate to settle on Mr. Jamie Francisco. And these guys are they majored in music, but they started doing other things in life. And this is the advantage from my perspective of how important it is to keep playing your instrument because it brings so much joy to you. These are two IT gentlemen over here. They are now working in computers. Fred is in the memoriam business, as he just said. In other words, he sells coffins. And Lee Brusino is retired. Band director, verified band director for many years in the Niagara school system, Niagara Wheatfield school system. But nonetheless, it got all through life, they kept their instruments up sometimes. It's you have to put a performance up, make yourself practice. There are a lot of incentives and nothing like doing a performance. And this is what we did throughout the 20 years that we played. Tonight, barring this suite, we just decided to play some pieces that we like. We certainly hope that you like them, but they've been a part of our repertoire for at least the last 20 years anyway, and we certainly hope that you like it. This first piece that we're going to play, Landscape, is written by a local composer who's from Grand Island, and writes for a lot of television and professional orchestras. So there's a sort of a local flavor in this piece that we're going to play for you. And it's always good. You don't necessarily have to start a half hour for the fanfare, but we decided to do because we couldn't choose between the two fanfares. So that's why you're hearing another fanfare. Okay? All right.
Thank you. solo. The next piece that you're going to hear, the Contrapunctus by Johann Sebastian Bach, was arranged by a gentleman by the name of Robert Nagel. Should be imported to you, or actually shouldn't be imported to you, but I'm going to tell you about it anyway. Robert Nagel was a trumpet professor and trumpet teacher, and he was one of the original members of the New York Brass Quintet. Why is that important? Well, the New York Brass Quintet was one of the first quintets to come on the scene and really popularize this ensemble and this and a lot of the genre of music. They are sort of been copied by Canadian brass, who sort of took the popular route. Canadian brass, the Empire Brass, the American Brass Quintet. All those guys sort of stem from the New York Brass Quintet. And Robert Nagel was one of the original trumpet players in that, as well as creating a lot of music through arrangements for our repertoire. And this particular arrangement that you're going to hear, this selection that you're going to hear is an arrangement done by Mr. Robert Nagel.
staple among the brass quintet repertoire. In fact, it was recorded by New York Brass Quintet. It's been recorded by many brass quintet. And it's just one of our earlier pieces that we played, and so we have a certain affinity for it. And we will close up our concert with this and another arrangement by Robert Nagel. I want to publicly tell you how much I love these guys and I appreciate them, their friendship. And I remember when, during COVID, I was standing, sitting at my house staring at the walls going, all the things that I missed, and I never told my friends how much I enjoyed playing with them. And when I saw them again, I apologized for it because I took it for granted. I took having my students around me and being able to see them every day, a lot of stuff for granted, and I will never do that again. I'm blessed to have four friends who are also accomplished musicians who will put up with me and my crazy ideas of playing recitals, which sometimes mean we practice on Saturday morning. All of us have jobs, and many of us play in various other groups, but they cannot robbery to come together. I mean, it's not just I dare say, it's not just the desire to play music together, but we genuinely care for each other, and that's a rarity to have among five guys. So again, I appreciate them greatly for 20 years, and hopefully we have 20 more years. They made a lot of jokes, and I was a buddy of a lot of jokes when I first got here because I was coming from Florida. And yeah, I'm very uncomfortable. No offense to Buffalonians, I love you guys. I'm a Buffalonian now, but when I got here, I certainly was not. And they had their field day with me when the temperature would drop because I was extremely uncomfortable. And now, you know, I'm a northerner because I can't stay in hot weather anymore. But anyway, this has been just a great, wonderful group. Is Dr. Filsinger out there? Was he here? Yeah, Dr. Filsinger also plays with this group. Whenever we have an opportunity to get him in here and to play, we certainly appreciate him as well. Again, don't close the concert up with the Ludwig Maurer three pieces.
Thank you.